Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video, let us learn about nested structures and self-referential structures. What is a nested structure? As the name says, if a structure is inside another structure, then we can say that it is a nested structure. Okay, is it possible? Can we write a structure inside another structure? So, yes. If a structure is declared inside another structure as its member, then we can call it as a nested structure. So, how to write it? Let us see. I had a structure E name with two members, first name and last name. And I am creating another structure employee. And the first member is actually the structure E name and to represent the name of the employee. And I got other members like age and salary. So, when we look at employee, this employee has another structure as its member. So, employee is a nested structure. Okay, it is very good. Then, if you have a structure as a member, then how to access the members of that structure? For example, in this case, how to access the first name of the employee or how to access the last name of the employee? So, we know that to access age or salary, we will use the variable, that is employee variable dot age, employee variable dot salary to access this member. Then how to access first name and last name from employee? Let us see. Accessing members of nested structures. So to access the members of a nested structure, the syntax we follow is write the name of the outer structure dot name of the inner structure dot member name. Let us see this. In the previous example, employee, I am creating employee E1. Struct employee E1, I created a variable E1. To access name of this one, E1 dot name dot F name. Okay, we will write a program for this and see how to access this. So, I am going into code blocks to write a program. Let us start from the scratch. Let us create a structure. So, let us use the same structures we used in the slides. Struct name, and I have two members, char, fname, then char, last name, lname, 20. Creating another structure, struct employee, struct name, ename. Ename is my variable there. Int is float don't worry about this float data type. Only to use different data types, I took salary as float. Salary may not be float in many cases. Int main. Let me create a variable for employee. Struct employee E1. And let me initialize this. Also observe how I am initializing. How to initialize this? If I give the name as some name, Raju, will it accept? So, name is actually a structure. So, we should, when we look at the structure, that is name. So, if I go here, it has got two members, first name and last name. So, while initializing this one, I should pass two arrays here. For example, R, Raju, comma. Now, his age is something like 54. And his salary something like 120,000. You can pass like this. So this is how we will initialize. Where I am passing two character literals, means strings. Why I am passing two strings here? Because I have two members here, first name and last name. So automatically R will be first name, Raju will be last name. Let us try to access them. I want to print the first name and last name. Printf. First name percentile s backslash n last name percentile s backslash n. So what should I pass here to access the member? I said that outer structure dot inner structure. Is it name or ename? I should write the name of the member. To access ename, I have to use e1.ename. So first of all, let us access ename. e1.ename dot. So now I want to access fname. That is one variable. Another one is e1 dot, exactly same process, outer structure dot ename, inner structure dot member name, lname. I want to print this. Return 0. Close the program. Let me compile. There were some errors expected. Let me see what is the error. So, is equal to semicolon. Let me see where I forget the semicolon. After structure, after members, after structure closing, main printf. Have I put a semicolon here? Yes. Return 0. Something wrong. So the error is that I have forgot to put this assignment operator here, s equal to. Well, let me compile again. So build finish 0 errors. Let me run the program. First name R, last name Raju, it is printed. So this is how we will access members of nested structures. Okay, let us go to our PPT again. Let us continue. So another topic is self-referential structures. As the name says, self-referential means the structure is referring to itself, or structure is referring to the same type of structure. Let me see. Self-referential structures are those structures which have one or more pointers which point to same type of structure. This is the point we should remember. So a self-referential structure will have one or more pointers, at least one pointer that points to the same type of structure. Let us look at an example to be clear. So here we are creating a struct, and the name of the struct is node. It has got members data 1, data 2, and when we look at the third member, this member is of type node. It is a pointer to the type node. So we call this as a self-referential structure because it points to same type of node, same type of structure. So a self-referential structure will have one or more pointers which points to same type of structure. This is how we define self-referential structures. Is it useful in any way? Do we have any applications for self-referential structures? So, when we ask this question, self-referential structures are very useful in creating data structures for numerous applications in computer science. Let us look at this example, the applications. We say that they are used in creation of data structures like linked lists, stacks, queues, trees, and graphs. Okay, this is where we are applying self-referential structures. Let us write a program on this also. Okay, I'm deleting this previous program. Hash include stdio.h. Then let me write struct. Struct node, exactly the same node I am creating. Int I as one member. Float f, my second member, and then struct node, I want to create a pointer, asterisk link. This is our structure. Int main, create a variable struct node. I am creating two nodes, n1 and n2. Let us assign values to n1. n1 dot I is equal to 10. n1 dot f is equal to 5.6. n1 dot link is equal to, here actually I have to assign address. For now I am making it null, that is it is pointing to nothing. So this pointer has null value. So let us also write n2. n2 dot I is equal to, I am taking some dot 34. n2 dot I f is equal to 56.5. n2 dot link is equal to null. So I can make a small change. I am making a small change. Let n1 point to n2. That is n1 is equal to address of n2, and let n2 dot link be null. Okay. So let me access the members of n2 using n1 link, because n1 member link is pointing to n2, we should be able to access the members of n2. So printf the members of n2 are printf percentile d percentile f, comma I want to access using n1, so n1 dot link arrow operator. So what is that? I want to access I, comma n1 dot link arrow operator f, close, return 0. Compile, run the program. So the members of n2 are 34 and 56.5. So we were able to access the members of n2 using a member in n1. This is how we will use self-referential structures. Okay, thank you so much for watching. I hope this helps you. If you are new to this channel, make sure you like, comment and subscribe to this channel. So I love to know what you think of this video. Please leave me a comment.